In this video, we're going to talk about an option in the Place Node tool called Catchment Delineation, which will read the terrain model that you select and automatically put in that drainage area for the node that you're placing automatically for you. So to demonstrate how the tool works, if I go to the Layout tab and I go to the Place Node tool, of course you set your feature definition to what you want it to be for that inlet that you're placing. And if you look on the end of your cursor now, you're going to see where you can select your terrain model, which that's what I'm going to do now. I'll select my reference element. And now in this tool, you're going to have this option that says Catchment Delineation, which if I check mark that on, this is where it'll go through there and automatically put in that drainage area, and it's reading it from that terrain model. And of course, you set your feature definition to what you need it to be. And for this example here, we have it set to streets and roofs. If you need it to change it to something else, that's underneath the urban folder or the rule folder, you could do that. And that just basically sets up your runoff coefficient for that particular one that you select. So now if I scroll through here, and I'm going to use my Civil AccuDraw to place this particular node from this center line, going to hit the tab key to my offset, and I'll hit the letter O, and I will select my alignment, and I will hit my tab key to get to my station, and my station is going to be 9 plus 0, 0, and my offset is going to be 19. And you'll see that I have it placed right there. If I want to accept that, I would just simply left click to accept it. Now you're going to get the option for your rotation mode. How do you want to be rotated? Do you want to be absolute or relative to the alignment? For this example here, I'm going to be relative to the alignment. Now, I could be relative to the actual curb and gutter that's going through there. I could use that. But for this example here, my curb and gutter is going along that alignment, so I could just use the alignment for this example. But you could probably use either or. So I will go ahead and accept the relative to alignment. And now it's going to give you the option to locate the reference element for the rotation. And I will just simply select this alignment. And now you'll notice that it's going to be relative to that alignment. So if I come in here and for my rotation, I'll just do a rotation of 0 and hit the tab key. And that's not what I want. So I'll just hit the tab key and go down and I'll go 180. And you'll see that it's going to be relative to that alignment. And now I can go ahead and accept that location. And if I hit the F4 key, you're going to notice that not only did it place the inlet, it also placed this drainage area. So that's what that catchment delineation does. It automatically creates the catchment area for that inlet that you placed. Now, one limitation with this right here is you can't select it and modify these points because it's reading it from the terrain model. So that's just one limitation that you do have. So if you know your drainage area is not that, you'd probably just need to delete it and put in your own drainage area using the Place Catchment tool right here. Now if I go down the alignment, let's say I go through here, I use the Place Node tool again. I'm going to select my reference element, which is going to be the terrain. I will use the catchment delineation again, and I'll hit the tab key, go to the offset, and I will select my alignment just to make sure I'm using it. And for my station, it's going to be 11 plus 0, 0 with an offset of 19. I will left click for the location of it. I do want it to be relative to the alignment, so I will select that option. I'm going to use my center line for the rotation of it, so I will select it. And of course this one here is going to be north 90 degrees west, very similar to the last one, so I will go ahead and select that rotation, that way it's rotated correctly. And now you'll see that it placed that drainage area out there for you because I had catchment delineation still turned on. So now if I hit the F4 key, I will clear that out. Now if I go back to my previous one, this is something that you'll have to look at. You'll notice that it placed this drainage area for this node here because it's reading it from the train, but the previous one, you'll notice that it's still going all the way down below here. So what we need to do on this one here is to actually update it. So if you're going down through there and you're placing your nodes and you need to update your drainage area because you added one, like what we did here, what you can do is come up to your inlet and select it. Whenever you get to that dynamic toolbar, there's an option in here that says Update Catchment for Inlets. If you click on that, it'll basically go through there, and if it finds any other ones down through there, it'll read that and automatically update your catchment area. So now you'll see that your catchment area is this now versus going all the way down like what it did before, because it knows that there's another inlet down below here. So that's where you would go through there and update your catchment areas. If you go up through here and you move some of these, that's where you could update those. So that's what the catchment delineation option does in the place node tool if you wish to utilize that.